guess I was going to write a whole album about them, but I never got around to it. But I did write one or two, so I'll throw one in right now. And I have a theory that American presidents alternate. You've got a really clever one, followed by a really stupid one, and it alternates like this. And the weird thing about the world and the way it works is that the stupid ones sometimes are actually better than the clever ones. An example of this was, actually they were both terrible, but I'm going to sing a song about Warren Harding, and we're doing... Warren Harding did pretty much everything wrong while he was in office, and he actually died in office, but he followed the cleverest president ever, Woodrow Wilson, the president of a college, and he was like fearfully intellectual, and he was the most idealistic president ever. He believed in the League of Nations, and he believed in world peace, and he believed that he, you know, alone could, after World War I, could sort out all the troubles in the world, and it killed him. And of course, he didn't achieve anything. None of the things that he wanted actually happened. So, you know, okay, Woodrow Wilson, Warren Harding, I don't know. I mean, Warren Harding, hey, the hell with it, let's party. Stayed up drinking with the press corps till 3 o'clock in the morning, smoking playing cards. I mean, like, you know, he's the anti-Wilson. Who's best? Well, actually, neither of them. So, this one goes like this. Don't leave.